So we're going to ask, we got a couple questions we've given them, and we're going to go on to those next, and they're going to give you their pointers and their selling tips that they've experienced. What's made them top sales agents when it comes to Montevideo? Okay, there we go. Okay, so you guys, what are the secrets you guys have for when you're selling Montevideo? What has been your secret to success?
Samples, making sure that I do have samples everywhere I go of each flavor of the tea and the coffee, and I've also drank it myself so I can testify to what it tastes like, how I feel after I'm done. And so when I give it to people to try it, I tell them if the hazelnut is really creamy, if it has the hazelnut flavor, I can describe what the tea and the coffee does.
Hi everyone, hope you're enjoying your time here. We're so fortunate, there's a lot of accountability partners out there. Can some of y'all stand up real quick? Yeah, all right, well they may be standing, they may not. But I've benefited so much from the accountability partners. Their ideas I've incorporated into the success I've had with Montevideo. And so the focus is mainly on showing people value and how they can benefit as a collateral benefit, lose weight, as an example. My wife has lost 50 pounds, not that she needed to, glad I said that, right? And I lost 86 pounds. And the second thing is simply to have a script ready to go and be prepared, as Irene already mentioned, so you understand your products.
What are both of your favorite flavors?
I like the medium roast, the Colombia Supremo, best.
I should change a different one, but I also like the medium.
Okay, who do you guys target when you guys are trying to sell Montevideo, and why do you guys target certain people?
I mainly target people that I've already given the samples to and asked them to try the coffee and the tea. But I also target people that I know that love the coffee or just love coffee in general and love tea in general. I target those people because I know, for example, the people that have actually tried the coffee and tea of Montevideo, and I followed up with them to find out how did you like it, what did you feel about it, how did it make you feel, those type things. And if they really enjoyed it, I would also give them another sample. So when I go back to ask them to become my customer, I don't usually have a problem with that.
What I actually enjoy the most is the opportunity to build networks. So back where we're at in the Maryland area, we have an organization which is international. It's called Business Network International. Their charter, they have to give you warm referrals. They can't give you leads. And so when someone comes to you, they actually purchase. So I was blessed to have 8 customers on the way down before I got here at 5 in the morning from BNI customer referrals.
Have you ever had just, do you guys just invite friends over? Do you just sample coffee, or do you maybe take it, you know, to church with you? How do you guys, you know, find, I mean, obviously we know that you go and you find your friends who you know drink coffee, but have you just brought like a cup with you and said, oh yeah, this is Montevideo? How do you guys, you know, introduce it to your friends maybe originally?
I've actually hosted coffee parties. I give them a name, like Sips and Sweets or an afternoon tea party, and I just invite them out. I tell them I have this product that's really healthy and good for them, and invite them. I ask them to RSVP if they're going to show up. When I do a Sips and Sweets party, I have Danish, the coffees, the teas, and I do surveys and ask them then, you know, to fill out the survey on how and what they felt about the coffee, how did it make them feel, that kind of thing also again.
The Legacy app and the Platinum Discount Network Plus has been invaluable to me. I simply send people the links for Montevideo and let them see it on their own, and then I follow up with the samples. Actually, we took some of the people in the BNI, gave them into the prizes that you're able to receive through the Platinum Discount Network Plus, and everybody likes free. And that's why we add the coupons whenever they purchase to get that discount. It's not the money, it's just the fact they're getting something, adding value.
Okay. Coffee got introduced to my household about a month ago. And it wasn't a matter of we were going to drink Montevita or not. That was going to be our new brand. However, when I brought it into the house, the first look was, seriously? Yes, yes. So, but once my wife tried the coffee, it is now the brand for the Harper household, and will be. Okay? So sometimes you just gotta introduce it. And fortunately, my wife is a great networker. So there's gonna be a lot of folks looking for Montevita coffee.
Real quick, families, for me, my experience, unlike some folks, have had a lot of success with their relatives. I've had not really much success with the relatives. So I started card parties, and I invite the relatives to come over and play cards. We share coffee and tea at the party. Of course, Montevita coffee and tea. On top of that, the winner of the card game receives a bag of coffee or a box of tea. Now I'm breaking through with the families, and they're actually asking me, this is really good. What else you got? So I have a little piece of paper that automatically sends them to my website and allows them to go ahead with the one-stop shop, pick what they'd like to take, whether it be coffee, tea, or other products and services.
Okay, so my favorite one question is, what's the one selling tip you guys all have that you guys can share right now to hopefully encourage some of our other reps to get where you guys are when it comes to selling coffee? Because, I mean, your numbers were huge. So, because when I looked at your reports and I pulled up to who had the most selling, you know, most sales for Montevita, the two of you guys were in the top. So what tip can you guys share with them that they can maybe join you at maybe the next event, and maybe if we do another one of these little Q&As about Montevita, they could possibly be up here as the top selling Montevita sales agent for 5 minutes?
Roscoe.
The one thing I find is that people put too much pressure on themselves. Everyone is trying to be perfect. Only God is perfect, and I give him praise and glory for everything. So don't try and be perfect. Just try and get one customer per day. And as we heard earlier, if you do one per day in 3 months, you've got 90 customers. So just take your list and go 1 to 5 and call 1 to 5 until you get at least one customer per day. And so we were blessed and able to do 42 in one day. That's the most I've ever done, just by doing one at a time. So the brain can do one, so just focus on one and just repeat it over and over and over again, and you get to 42.
Thank you.